Okay, student. So today we see that is about the phases of growth. In last lecture we have seen how the types of the meristem, that is the meristematic tissue, were present. Today we see that is about the phases of the growth. So here the plant when gets, that is seeds when gets germinate, that is see here is the germinated seed, in which here the this portion, it is the radical, while here is the plume. Okay, so here the phases of growth, these are mainly shown, that is in the germinated seed, that is here in the germinating seed. So here is the radical from which here the root system is developed, and this portion, it is known as the plume. This portion is known as the plume. So here from this plume, here the shoot formation takes place, while from this radical, here the root formation takes place. So today we see that is about what are the phases of the growth. Okay, so see, that is here first phase of the growth, that is at this region. So this region, to this region, there is the phase of the cell division, or there is the phase of the cell formation. So here the cell division takes place, so it is known as the zone of cell division. Okay, so it is the region that is known as the zone of cell division, or it is also known as the zone of the cell formation. Okay, so it is also known as zone of cell formation. Okay, then next phase of the growth, that is the phase of elongation, and that is this region is from here, that is above the zone of cell division. Here is the zone of cell elongation. Zone of cell elongation. Zone of cell elongation. Okay, so here in the zone of cell division, that is here the only the cell division takes place due to the presence of their meristematic tissue, which divides and redivides. Why here the zone of elongation, here enlargement of the zone takes place, enlargement of the cells takes place. So it is also known as the zone of elongation, or it is also the increasing phase. Okay, or it is also enlargement of the cell takes place. Then here above this zone of elongation, there is the another zone, that is here, that is there is the zone of cell differentiation. Zone of cell differentiation. Cell differentiation. Zone of cell differentiation. And above the zone of cell differentiation, here is the zone of the maturation. That is, there are the mature cells. Okay, so here the zone of mature cell. Zone of mature cells. That is known as the zone of maturation. So here there are the different zone of the growth, that is which takes place in the plants, that is see here in the germinated seeds, that is here is the germinated seed. Okay, and when seed gets germinate, here there is the formation of the radical. Okay, and there is the formation of the plume. So here during the growth, here there are the different zones or the phases of the growth. Okay, so here first phase, that is here at which here there is the cell division takes place. Then after the cell division, the cell gets elongate, that is elongation zone. Okay, then again the cell differentiation takes place and the cell gets mature. Okay, so these are the different phases of the growth. So first, see, that is about the cell zone of cell elongation. sorry zone of cell division or the zone of cell formation. So first, that is the zone of cell division. Division, or it is also known as zone of cell formation. Zone of cell formation. Okay, so see here, that is if we see the phases of the growth, the first phase, that is the at which here the cell division takes place. So here is the first phase of the growth. Okay, and then second phase of the growth, that is the cell elongation takes place. That is here the second phase of the growth. And third phase, that is in which cell differentiation and the cell it gets mature. Okay, so here there is the third phase. Okay, so it is the third phase. Okay, so these are the three phases of the growth. The cell differentiation and the cell maturation together, that is this phase is the zone phase of the maturation or the zone of the mature cells, in which here the cell gets differentiation and also the cell gets mature. Okay, so first scene, that is about the cell division or the cell formation phase, or the so in this phase, that is in this region, that is in the zone of cell division, at this region there are the presence of the meristematic tissue. So this cell division or the cell formation, it mainly takes place, that is only at the shoot apex or root apex. Shoot apex or the root apex, in this region here the only the cell division or the cell formation takes place, and it is due to the presence of, that is the meristematic tissue. There are the meristematic tissue. Okay, in last lecture we have seen, that is about the meristem. Different types of the meristem, in which here the how the meristems are, that is types of the meristem depending upon their positions. Okay, so see there, that is here the meristematic cells, which is having the high capacity of the cell division. Okay, so here the meristematic cells are present at this region, and due to which here there is the cell division or the cell formation takes place. Okay, so see, that is here, what are the characteristics of this meristematic tissue or the cells which are present at the zone of cell division. Okay, so first characteristic, that is these cells, they are compactly arranged. Okay, so the cells are compactly arranged. Cells are compactly arranged. That is, in between the cell there is no intercellular space. म्हणजे दोन सेलच्या मध्ये इथं स्पेस नसतो. सगळे सेल्स हे एकमेकाला असे कॉम्पॅक्टली अरेंज असते. दॅट इज द सेल्स आर कॉम्पॅक्टली अरेंज. द नेक्स्ट, दॅट इज द न्यूक्लियस इज प्रॉमिनंट. न्यूक्लियस इज प्रॉमिनंट. लार्ज न्यूक्लियस या सेल्समध्ये आपल्याला पाहायला मिळेल. न्यूक्लियस इज प्रॉमिनंट. देन द प्रोटोप्लाझम, दॅट इज द ग्रॅन्युलर प्रोटोप्लाझम. प्रोटोप्लाझम इज अ ग्रॅन्युलर प्रोटोप्लाझम. देन हियर इन दिस सेल, दॅट इज द सेल वॉल इज थिन. Cell wall is thin. Okay, and then vacuoles are absent. Okay, so in this sense, that means the vacuoles are absent. Okay, so here, see, that is the cells are the immature. Cells are immature, and here at this region, the cells which are having the high capacity of cell division. cells having the high capacity of a cell division. Okay, so see, that is here, these cells which are made up of the meristematic so here in the meristematic cells which are having the high capacity of the cell division, due to which here the meristematic tissue which remains active throughout the life. Okay, जो पर्यंत प्लांट बॉडी आहे तो पर्यंत त्या प्लांट बॉडी मध्ये हे सेल्स हे नेहमी कसे राहतात, ऍक्टिव्ह राहतात, त्यामुळे प्लांट मध्ये कंटिन्यूअस ग्रोथ आपल्याला पाहायला मिळेल. ओके, सो हियर, सो सी, दॅट इज हाऊ द ग्रोथ टेक्स प्लेस ऑफ द मेरिस्टमॅटिक टिश्यू. दॅट इज सी हियर, सपोज हियर इज द मेरिस्टमॅटिक सेल. ओके, सी इट इज द मेरिस्टमॅटिक सेल, अँड व्हेन इट डिवाइड्स बाय द मायटोसिस, divides by the mitosis, that is after mitosis there are the formation of two cells. Here is the one cell, here is the another cell. Okay, there is the formation of the two cells, out of which one cell becomes remains as the meristematic. This cell which remain as the meristematic, it remain as the meristematic, while here the another cell it gets differentiated. Okay, so another cell, that is there is the elongation and the differentiation takes place. So here this cells it goes this next phase, that is the elongation phase. Okay, so here the elongation and differentiation takes place. Elongation and differentiation takes place of this cell. Okay, see, that is here. Here is the meristematic cell. Okay, which is present at the zone of the cell division. Okay, so at this zone of the cell division, here the cells which are the meristematic cells. This meristematic cell when get divides by the mitosis, it produces the two cells, out of which one cell remain as a meristematic, which again gets divides. Okay, while the another cell it mainly gets differentiate or the elongate. Okay, so due to which here there is the increase in the height or the increase in the length of the plant takes place. Okay, so here these meristematic cells which are mainly the active throughout the life of the plant. Okay, so see, that is here. During the cell zone, in the zone of the cell division, that is here, it is known as the lag phase. It is known as the lag phase. That is the first phase is the lag phase. This phase is known as the lag phase. Why? Because here the rate of the growth is very slow. Rate of growth is very slow, but time required is the maximum. But time required is the maximum. If we plot the graph, that is growth rate against the time required, here we can see, that is here the growth rate is very slow. Okay, growth rate is very slow. That is the minimum growth rate. While here the time required, which is the maximum time is required. Okay, so here it is known as the lag phase. म्हणून या फेजला काय म्हटलं जातं, लॅग फेज, की जेणेकरून या फेजमध्ये रेट हा ग्रोथ रेट हा काय असतो तर मिनिमम असतो, आणि टाइम मात्र काय असतो लागतो याला जास्त लागतो. ओके, सो स्लो डाऊन. ओके, लॅग म्हणजे काय म्हणतो आपण त्याला, स्लो ग्रोथ होते. ओके, सो सी, इट इज अबाउट द सेल झोन ऑफ द सेल डिव्हिजन अँड इट इज नोन ॲज द लॅग फेज. या सेल डिव्हिजनच्या झोनमध्ये जे काही ग्रोथ असते त्या ग्रोथच्या फेजचं नाव आहे लॅग फेज. इट इज द नोन ॲज द लॅग फेज. ओके, सो इट इज द फर्स्ट फेज, दॅट इज द झोन ऑफ द सेल डिव्हिजन ऑर द सेल फॉर्मेशन, इन विच हिअर द वी हॅव सीन, दॅट इज द इट इज द लॅग फेज. इट इज नोन ॲज द लॅग फेज. Okay, so in this region, that is continuous cell division takes place. Why? Because there are the presence of the meristematic tissue, and this meristematic tissue which is having the thin cell wall, that is the cells are the in immature condition, that is in which here vacuoles are absent. Then again we have seen that is in which here the granular protoplasm is present, nucleus is prominent. Okay, so these are some characteristics of the cells which are present in the zone of cell division or the cell formation. Then next is, that is about the next phase is the zone of the cell elongation. Zone of cell elongation. So after the zone of cell division, here is the zone of cell elongation. So this zone of cell elongation, it is known as the exponential phase. Exponential phase. Or it is also known as the log phase. It is also known as the log phase. Okay, so this phase in which there is the increase in the size of the cells takes place. That is in the zone of elongation. So it is also known as the increasing phase. Increasing phase. It is also known as the increasing phase. So here in this region, what happens? That is the cell gets elongate. That is here the cell elongation takes place. So how the cell elongation takes place? That is here in this cell region. That is there is the accumulation of the solute takes place. In this region here. Accumulation of solute inside the cell takes place, and when the inside the cell here solute accumulation takes place, then what happens? There endosmosis takes place. Okay, and due to this endosmosis here, the cell becomes sturgy. We have seen in last topic, that is how the cell becomes sturgy. Okay, so here the endosmosis takes place and the cell becomes sturgy. Okay, so here the size of the cell, it mainly increases lengthwise and also the breadthwise. Okay, so there is increase in length and also breadth of cell. Okay, या condition मध्ये काय होईल तर cell ची size increase होईल, म्हणजे lengthwise आणि breadthwise ही cell काय होईल, there is the increase in the size of the cell. Okay, and then here in this cell, here the endosmosis takes place, cell becomes sturgy, and the here the length and the breadth also increases, and there is the development of the vacuoles. That is in these cells, that is the vacuoles are developed. Vacuoles develops. Okay, in this phase, that is in the cell division phase, vacuoles are absent. While in the zone of cell elongation, at this region, what happens? That is, there is the formation of the vacuoles takes place. Okay, so here the then again the cell it becomes the cell wall it becomes thick. Okay, in the cell zone of cell division, we have seen that is the cell wall is thin. Okay, while here in this phase, that is the cell wall which becomes thick. Cell wall becomes thick. So see, that is here how the cell wall becomes thick. That is the due to the deposition of cellulose. due to the deposition of cellulose. So here the cellulose, it gets deposit, that is in the two processes, that is one is the apposition. Cellulose deposition is this. Cellulose deposition होता म्हणजे काय होता तर त्या सेल वरती, सेल वॉल वरती काय होता तर सेल्युलोजचं काय होता तर थर साचायला सुरुवात होते. ओके, आणि त्यामुळे हा जो सेल वॉल आहे तो काय बनतो, थिक बनतो. ओके, सो हियर द सेल्युलोज सेल्युलोज डिपॉजिशन इट मेनली टेक्स प्लेस, दॅट इज बाय द टू वेज. वन इज द अपोजिशन, वन इज द अपोजिशन, एंड अनदर इज द इंटरसेप्शन. इंटरसेप्शन सेकेंड इज द intersusception. Okay, so see, that is here how the intersusception takes place and the how the apposition takes place. That is here the cell wall, it mainly becomes thick due to the deposition of the cellulose. So how the cellulose deposition takes place? In the apposition, that is in the apposition process, that is here suppose here is the cell wall. Cell wall, and here is the cell membrane. Here is the cell membrane. So what happens, that is the deposition of the cellulose, it takes place, that is below the cell wall. Below the cell wall, that is here in between the cell wall and the cell membrane. Okay, so below the cell wall, here the deposition of the cellulose takes place. Okay, it is known as the apposition. While intersusception means what? That is here in the intersusception, that is here the cellulose deposition on the cell wall takes place, that is in the cell wall. That is, see, that is here is the cell wall. So here in the cell wall there is the deposition of the cellulose takes place. Okay, so here there is the deposition of the cellulose takes place on the cell wall. Okay, and if it takes place below the cell wall, it is the apposition. Okay, and it is the intersusception. Okay, so these are the two ways here how, that is, the cellulose deposition takes place and the cell wall becomes thick. Okay, so here during this, in this zone, that is the in the zone of cell elongation, here the growth of the cell it takes place immediate, that is here the cell it grows immediately. Okay, so there is the maximum growth of the cell takes place. Okay, and here the time required is very slow, that is time required is minimum. Okay, time required is the minimum. So here the rate of growth is maximum. Okay, in the zone of cell elongation, here in the maximum growth is maximum, and time which is required, it is the minimum. So it is known as the log phase, or it is known as the exponential phase. It is known as the exponential phase. Okay, so in this phase here the enlargement and the elongation of the cell takes place. Okay, so it is about the zone of cell elongation. Okay, so the in the zone of cell elongation, it is, there is the increase in the size of the cell takes place, that is the length wise and the breadth wise. Okay, so how it gets increased, that is there is the deposition of the cell wall. Okay, that is the cellulose deposition which takes place on the cell wall, due to which the cell wall becomes thick. The vacuole formation also takes place, and most important, that is there is the accumulation of the solute, and due to the accumulation of the solute here the endosmosis takes place and the cell becomes turgid. sail becomes a turgid. Okay, so it is about the zone of sail elongation. Okay, or it is also known as exponential phase, or it is also known as the log phase. Then next is that is about the third phase, that is the zone of the mature sails. Zone of maturation, or it is also known as the zone of the mature phase. Okay, so here zone of mature phase, that is here the sail maturation phase. Zone of sail maturation. So here in the zone of sail maturation, what happens? That is, there is the maturation of the sails takes place. Means what here? The sail, it becomes mature. That is, after the differentiation of the sails, here the sails becomes mature. That is, in this phase here, actually working of the sails takes place. Okay, that is here the there are formation of simple tissue, that is parenchyma, collenchyma, sclerenchyma. Then again complex tissue formation takes place, that is the xylem and the phloem. Okay, and due to which here there are the cell which becomes mature. Okay, so here in during this phase here at this phase is known as the stationary phase. This phase is known as the stationary phase. That is, during this phase here, the growth of the cell, it gets slow down. Growth of the cell, it gets slow down. Okay, so growth is slow. That is, there is the minimum growth takes place. While here, in the time required, it is the maximum. Okay, so in this here there is the formation of the differentiation of the cells, and due to the differentiation of the cell there are the formation of different types of the cells, that is the epidermal cell, cortical cells. Okay, then inside which there are the some endodermis is developed. Okay, in this way here there are in the zone of the mature cells, at this zone here, this is the together phase, that is the in this region here there is the third phase, that is in which here there is the cell differentiation takes place, and also here the cell, it becomes mature. Cell becomes mature. Okay, so it is about the phases of growth. It is about the phases of growth. Okay, then the next that is about the graphical representation. म्हणजे आता जे काही आपण या फेजेस बघितल्यात त्याचं आपण ग्राफिकल रिप्रेझेंटेशन बघूया. Graphical representation of the phases of growth. So here if we see the graphical representation, that is there is the growth rate, which is the mainly that is plant growth, it mainly calculated, that is how the growth rate, that is here the graph which is plotted, that is growth rate against the time. Okay, so here is the time and here is the growth rate. Here is the growth rate. Okay, so here see, that is it is mainly shows, that is the sigmoid curve. It is known as the sigmoid curve. Yes, shift curve. Okay, so here see, that is how the growth rate is That is, here the growth rate is slow, then again it's increased, and then again here is the stationary phase. Okay, so here at this region, here is the this phase, it is the lag phase. It is the log phase. And it is the stationary phase. Stationary phase. Okay, so in the cell, what happens is that is in the lag phase, the growth rate is minimum. Growth rate is minimum. So see, that is here. If we see, that is the growth rate in the lag phase is the minimum, while here time which is required is maximum. So see, that is here, it is the minimum growth rate. Okay, here is the minimum growth rate. इथून इथपर्यंत आपण पाहिला तर हा ग्रोथ रेट हा काय आहे मिनिमम आहे व्हाइल द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड इट इज द मॅक्सिमम टाइम इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द लॅग फेज ओके व्हाइल इन द लॉग फेज सी दैट इज हियर द ग्रोथ रेट इज मॅक्सिमम ग्रोथ रेट इज मॅक्सिमम ओके लाइक दिस सो फ्रॉम दिस रीजन टू दिस रीजन हियर द ग्रोथ रेट इज मॅक्सिमम maximum growth rate. While here the time which is required, so this region to this region, here in the time which is required, it is the minimum time is required. Minimum time is required. While if we see in the stationary phase, that is in the stationary phase here, the growth rate again slow down. Growth rate जर बघितलं तर तो पुन्हा slow down होतो. It is so the minimum growth rate. It is the minimum growth rate. While here, the in the stationary phase here, the time which is required, it is the maximum. Okay, time which is required is the maximum. Okay, so it is about the graphical representation of the three pages of the. Okay, so here there are the three pages. First is the lag phase, another is the log phase, and stationary phase. Stationary phase, it is also known as the steady phase. It is also known as the steady phase. Log phase, it is known as the exponential phase. It is known as the exponential phase. While here, lag phase, it is in which here the growth rate is very slow. Okay, so it is about the graphical representation of the three phases of the growth. Okay. So next we see that is about some conditions which are required for the growth. So in the plant body, for the growth of the plant, there are some environmental conditions are required. That is, which are the conditions required for the growth. So first condition is the water. So water is most essential, that is for the photosynthesis also. Okay, and water, it maintain the turgidity of the cell. Okay, so here the it is mainly component of the protoplasm. Water he kaya hai, protoplasm cha component hai, ani cell chi turgidity maintain karnyacha kaam he kon karta, water karta. So first condition is the water. Then second condition is the gravitational force. Gravitational force. Okay, so here the gravitational force, it mainly useful, that is, it mainly decide the growth of the shoot and also the root. Okay, so it decide the growth of the shoot and the म्हणजे direction. Shoot जर बघितलं आपण तर ते opposite gravitational force मध्ये वाढतं, root जर बघितलं towards the gravitational force वाढतं. Okay, and then third condition is the nutrients. Third is the nutrients. So we have seen that is there are the macronutrients and the micronutrients which are required for the growth. We have seen in the last topic which are the there are the 16 nutrients, micronutrients. So the essential elements. There are the 16, in which there are the macronutrients and also the micronutrients. Then next, that is temperature. Fourth is the temperature. So for the plant growth, here the optimum temperature which is required, it is of the 25 degrees Celsius to the 35 degrees Celsius. Temperature which is optimum temperature, it is required. And this temperature, it mainly required for the proper actions of the enzyme. Okay, so for the enzymatic actions, here temperature is required. Then fifth condition is the oxygen. So oxygen, it mainly required for the process of the photosynthesis. Okay, we have seen that is the oxygen, it is required for the process of the respiration, and for the photosynthesis carbon dioxide is required. Okay, so here oxygen, which is required for the process of the respiration, so during the process of the respiration, here the large amount of energy is released out. Okay, so here the in the process of respiration, there is the breakdown of the glucose, and due to which here there is the formation of simple compounds, that is carbon dioxide and the water molecule. Okay, so during the respiration process, CO2 is released and large amount of, that is 686 kilocalorie energy is produced. Okay, so oxygen is also the most essential factor for the growth of the plant. And then next, that is about the light. So we know that is for the process of the photosynthesis, light is essential. Okay, so here during the process of the photosynthesis, CO2 and water is used, then again light is required, and in presence of the light, the plants prepare the food material. Okay, so it is about the conditions which are mainly required for the growth of the plant. Okay, so these conditions, these are the water, gravitational force, nutrients, temperature, oxygen and the light. Okay, student, today we stop here.